Hi, this is May 18th, and I have several calls from people asking me how to pluck their puppy's ears. It's something that's really important that you do and maintain if you're going to groom at home, but if you're going to go to a groomer, at least you should know what to look for when you get back from the groomer. So I have my guinea pig little poodle puppy. She's got really hairy ears, so we decided that we'd show you her ears. The biggest thing when you go to do ears, there's a couple things you're going to need in your arsenal. You're going to need some ear cleaner. And do not use soap and water. You need some ear cleaner with some aloe, alcohol, some astringent in it, so their ears do dry and they don't stay moist. The other thing you'll need is an ear plucking powder, which this one happens to be from Pet Edge, which is a great place to get it. I think this runs $6 or $7 for an 80 gram bottle. So I would check prices on PetEdge.com. This is nothing more than a gripping powder to let you pull the hair out of their ears. It doesn't have any astringent value, medical value, nothing. Just lets you help to pull the hair out when it's oily and won't slip through your hands. So those two things are extremely important. In fact, you can't do it without ear powder. A lot of you have told me that, oh, I just cut the hair out of my dog's ears. That doesn't work because you're cutting it off. You're still leaving the hair down in that canal to block the air from circulating. The other thing you'll need is some Q-tips. Regular Q-tips at home are fine. We just go through so many hundred a year that we buy them in bags of 100 at a time. All right, so let's start on Tinker's ears. I let these grow purposely, not cleaning them, not doing anything to them for about 13, 14 weeks because I wanted to be able to show you this. This is an average hair growth you're going to have. Unfortunately, the schnoodles get the hair from their ancestor, the poodle. Schnauzers don't have quite as much. If this stays in here and stays blocked with the ear over and no air circulating, she will get a yeast infection in this ear. So the first thing I'm going to do is, I usually do this on a groom table, but you can do this way at home too. You can pin them between your knees. You don't want to be their best friend, so you're not going to want to talk to them. Don't use a baby voice. Don't make them pay attention to you. They're here to do something, and they have to sit here till you're done. She's a little bit shaky because she doesn't really know what we're going to do to her yet. I'm going to take the ear powder, and I'm going to sprinkle it freely in her ear. Most people have a tendency to want to come in here and pat it around. You don't want to do that. Just leave it set. Then you're going to grab small portions of the hair. I'm going to save this for you and show you. I better put it down here. It's windy. Whoop, there went my hair. Well, we'll try and show you how much we get out of here. And I'm going to go in here and I'm going to pull little pieces. Now, some of you might pull your puppy's ears and pluck them like this, and the puppy may scream bloody murder. Let me see if I can hide this hair without it blowing somewhere. This is like plucking your eyebrows for the first time. It's not very comfortable. So this ear is a great handle. Hold their ear, use your thumb and your index to control this ear. And that way, and you can also, if they sit still, let that hand go. You can turn this ear inside out. There's a big area right there that has a lot of hair that comes out of it. And you want to keep right on plucking. Don't be surprised if you have, there's a little spot, I just saw it. If you pull a chunk out, sometimes you'll leave it red. It might even look like it's going to bleed a little bit. It's like where there's a little capillary at. But it is irritating to the ear for the first time. But this is something that's extremely important. Whether you have a schnoodle, especially if you have a poodle, she says, ugh. Now I probably could get down in here easier if I had a hemostat or a pair of tweezers. I don't want to do that. Because if I do and I pinch her, she's never going to let me do this again. And you can clean off this ear leather as far up as you want to go on your puppy. Alright, there's kind of a pre-look, and I haven't cleaned it yet. So then I'm going to take the ear cleaner, and I'm going to put a few squirts down in their ear, turn her around, and put some pressure on it and kind of washboard it back and forth. Because I'm doing like a scrubbing motion where I'm cleaning that ear out. Then I take a couple of Q-tips, and I go right down in this ear. And I go about the length of the Q-tip in here. I'm not going down in, I'm not going to injure the eardrum. I'm really just going all around this ear. I'm cleaning it out, cleaning the dirt out. She doesn't have too dirty of ears. That's a good thing. If you get a black gunk out of your ear and it's smelly, you probably have an ear infection.
Now, if Becky can get down in here and show you, there's that ear canal, really cleaned out, really nice. And stay there, Beck, and I'll show you the dirty one. There's the one we haven't done yet. Huge, huge difference. She says, ah, okay, let's turn you around. And we'll do this ear also. What's our time like, Beck?
5:17.
Okay. All right, we're going to sprinkle the powder in here. Ooh, I really got you powdery that time. And I'm just going to start plucking. Oh, I was going to show you. This is everything that came out of her ear canal, minus the little chunk that flew off in the breeze a few minutes ago. So there is a lot that comes out of these ears. It's amazing how much they have. This does get easier on the puppy as they get older. It's kind of like women that pluck their, let me turn him where I can get a hold of him. When they pluck their eyebrows, it seems to get easier as you age. It also slows the hair growth down. It's not something you'll ever be completely rid of doing, unfortunately, but this takes at least 8 to 10 weeks to get this long again. Pulling that from way down in, those are long pieces. So there's no sense in even trying to do this again before 8 to 10 weeks from now. So this is something that is, if you go to a groomer, make sure you look at your dog's ears before you leave the grooming parlor. If they are not cleaned out and they don't look as clean as Tinker's does when I'm finished, ask him to go back in and clean them again. That's probably the most important part of your grooming that you're going to get from your groomer is your ears, your toenails. I'd say ears are top on the list. Toenails are second, and anal glands and a hygiene clip are third. All right, now let's go in here and put some cleaner in there. I know that's cold, isn't it, Tinker? And I'm going to scrub that back and forth, clean that all around. Take my Q-tips, go down in here and clean this out. All right, and there's that ear all finished and cleaned out. If there's a lot of hair right in front of the ears, she's pretty wet to do this, but if there's a lot of hair here on a schnoodle, because you don't trim them like a poodle, I would trim the hair out right in front of her ears. That way when this ear hangs down, it still lets the air get up in there and circulate. You needed your ears trimmed a little bit better anyway, I missed you. All right, so I hope that helps. If you have any questions or you want my homemade recipe for my ear cleaner, please drop me an email or give me a call, and I'll be glad to help you with any of your questions. So good luck on plucking your ears.